Okay, we finally arrived at this last piece, last part of the High Performance Container Workshop in 2020. Today, and this is a virtual edition, of course, we are going to talk about HPC specifics in the first part and outlook and use cases in the second part of this day. The first one, again, is HPC specifics. And we have like five or four lightning talks. First, CJ will talk about HPC device integration. So how does device mapping, kernel and user land drivers are involved? Saba, Bill, and Luca will discuss how containers scale. So what's the difference between an on-prem cluster where you have shared file systems and maybe diskless nodes in contrast to maybe a normal container cluster where you have independent nodes that can go away and that's the difference between them. Then Saba will talk about the high and low lights when moving HPC apps and discussing like the HPC specific pieces that hinders and that throw sticks and stones in your way. It's going to be an interesting one. And last but not least, Josh will talk about MPI and PMI and an update. So that's something that I wanted to talk about during this workshop for a long time. So now I finally have it. So that's pretty cool. And after that, we will have the live panel discussion and the Q&A. So if you have questions throughout, throw it in the HPCW20 channel, in the HPC containers community Slack. Login or invites are in the website of the workshop, hpcw.github.io. Tenants are all things HPC, so not really much tenants. I would hope that we don't talk about orchestration and scheduling so much because that's what we discussed yesterday. And but this time, I mean, feel free to discuss everything. I think missing in action for this segment, we wanted to talk about POSIX storage and integration. Somehow we couldn't find someone in this short notice, so that's something that is on the agenda for next time. And also HPC app lifecycle management, what is different between HPC and non-HPC apps. So that's something, and that's like question is where to put it, maybe in the build distribute segment, that's to be seen. What you should look out for is how does PMI change the landscape as a stand-in for other like traditional ways of doing HPC. With PMI, you don't need an SSH server anymore, which is a relief, right? Because containers, it's pretty scary to have SSH daemons. And how does HPC breaks with the user and kernel space paradigm? I think normally containers should contain, but we break it up because we need access to devices, like hardware, like bare metal access to the devices with bare metal speeds. And we need POSIX file system access, which is also something that normal containers won't do, and we have containers working together with MPI, so that's something that break the normal paradigm with containers. Okay, now I'm going to roll the videos and then we will meet again in 45 minutes or so. Please put everything in Slack. There are no dumb questions. Just put it in, we will discuss it. And we will see each other in a couple of minutes. So enjoy the videos.